Is it possible to restore an engine that has seized up, that has failed because it has not had oil in it? In a previous video, I compared Slick 50 to SAE 30. I added oil to one engine, and then I added oil with Slick 50 to another engine, and that was this lawnmower here. This lawnmower lasted a little over 2 minutes before it seized up. Now, on a positive note, this engine isn't totally locked up, but it's very stiff to turn over. I can't get this engine to start just from using the pull rope because it is way too stiff. So today, we're going to see if we can get this engine running again and see if we can get it running well. All right, let's measure how much torque it takes to spin the engine over. Looks like it's around 35 before it starts to spin. So that's a lot of resistance. This thing is tight. You can hear it squeaking. It's biting inside the engine. I don't want to spin it over too much because that's going to do more damage, and we want to try to restore this engine. So now let's see what kind of torque it takes to spin over the engine that has never had any damage. As you can see, this engine rotates freely, takes absolutely no effort at all. The spark plugs are out on both these mowers. You can just literally move this with the finger. I'm hoping you can see it, but there's a significant amount of scoring on these cylinder walls from not having oil in the crankcase and being ran dry. So hopefully we can restore this engine and get this engine running again, but it'll never be the same. This is the right side of the cylinder wall. As you can see, there's a lot of scoring on this side. Additionally, there's a very deep cut right here in this cylinder wall. Okay, to try to bring this engine back to life, I'm going to put Marvel Mystery Oil to good use, and also I'm sparing no expense. I'm going to try using some Mobil 1 synthetic, and according to the instructions on Marvel Mystery Oil, it can be used in the crankcase to enhance lubrication. It also says to use up to 20% of what's put in the crankcase with Marvel Mystery Oil. So this crankcase is going to hold around 20 ounces. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and add 4 ounces of Marvel Mystery Oil. And then I'm going to add the rest all the way up to about the 20 ounce mark with the Mobil 1 synthetic. So I'm going to use PB Blaster to lubricate the cylinder real well and see if that will cause the engine to spin over a little more freely. So now I'm going to go ahead and manually rotate the cylinder. This thing is really, really stiff. I can hear the rings gouging into the cylinder walls. That thing's extremely stiff. It's continuing to free up. I'm gonna go ahead and spin the engine over a few times using the pull rope for starting. Alright, we've got the Marvel Mystery Oil and Mobil 1 in the crankcase. There's no point in taking a torque measurement. The engine is spinning very freely. So we're going to see if we can get this engine to start. This thing has a bad knock, so we're going to go ahead and see what kind of compression we have. But even if this thing has great compression, this thing has a big issue going on inside the engine. Several of you wrote in and suggested I try to get this engine going again, so just want to say thank you for that recommendation. This was a good project to get this going again, and you guys gave me some good advice on the best strategy to take to get the engine going. Marvel Mystery Oil, as well as Mobil 1, really did a great job as far as loosening up the crankcase, the connecting rod. By the same token, this engine has a pretty bad knock. And as you could also see, there's some pretty bad damage to the cylinder wall, and the compression is low. So my question to you is, which of the products in front of me do you think would provide the best results for improving the compression as well as for reducing some of that noise that we hear coming from the crankcase? Obviously, this engine is never going to be right. It's never going to be like it was when it was new. By the same token, for the skeptics out there, the purpose of the video series is to test the claims of these manufacturers. If they say they can improve the compression, then this is a great engine to use for that purpose. Additionally, if they say they can reduce some of the engine noise, this again is a great engine to use for that purpose. Some people probably thinking, you know, this is a big waste of money and time. Well, I really do like the idea of testing the claims of these manufacturers, because people are spending tens of millions of dollars on these products, and I really want to see if these products are really as good as the manufacturer claims they are. But as usual, I really enjoy reading your comments, and I hope you'll take time to vote and let me know which product I should test on this engine. And as always, thanks for watching the video, and look forward to seeing you next time.